press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
So another related question, at what stage of the plot did you come up with this name?
I think fairly late into the plot. I think I had probably written about 90% of the story, and I was dabbling with, okay, how should I end it? And once I knew how I wanted to end it, I figured this makes a whole lot of sense, because it's the son who comes back but really does not come back, right? And why I did not name it the Unprodigal Son is because it's not just about the son, but each and every one in the story. So, and when you read it, you'll realize that everyone is the unprodigal. Yeah.
Thanks and congratulations once again.
Thank you.
So I just wanted to say that we know each other for 20 years now, right? I mean, that's a long time. We've grown up together in our own, into our own individuals that we are, and hopefully we'll continue to grow together. And I'm not surprised at all that this is out there. You know, I know, obviously, because, you know, I'm with you, I've seen creativity bubble in various ways over the last two decades, you know. Even in the most mundane corporate jobs, how can one get creative is what I've seen and observed very closely. And I have told this to you before, and I've felt it always, that there's so much more to you that you should be putting out there to the wider audience for them to chew on and for them to review and critique if need be, right? And I'm just so glad that you did it, because we all get into our comfort zones. It takes a push once in a while to get out of it. I'm really, really very happy for you, as well as for the various others who will hopefully get motivated and follow you. So I'm very happy.
Thank you so much.
It's a very natural progression of who you are. I sound like a third person right now, but I really wanted to say it. And I also want to say for all the three of us, for me and the two daughters, the three girls in the house, the 10-year-old Myra and the 4-year-old Kimaya, we are all very, very proud of you. The girls already know that Dad is going to live through his books, through his various radio interviews and the other things that he's doing. They're very happily showing it off to all their friends. They're very busy influencing them to buy Papa's book.
I've trained them well, I guess.
Very well. So I just want to say that the most proud person who would have been is your mother, because she loved you the most, and you loved her the most. And you know, as we all know, that before going, she encouraged you to take the path. She gave you the last push. I'm so glad she did. She always wanted you to be you know, the big person in the corporate world and all of that, but then she said that, you know, let the creativity bubble. And I'm so glad, and I know what to say that, but I just want to say that Mom would be very, very proud of you, and she's showering her love for wherever she is.
Thank you, Nidhi. Thanks for saying it. Thank you.
So, the whole writing process, when you said you started with no plot and didn't really know where it was, you started writing, and then over time you realized that writing.
Shruti, very interesting question, and I think, you know, I said this earlier also, I think, you know, if you can find yourself, success does find you, and I truly, truly believe it, you know, and I realize that when you're passionate and happy about doing something, when it really sort of gives you those goosebumps and heart jumps, it doesn't feel like work. So you can, you know, even forget writing. I realized writing was easy. When the book started, you know, with coming out, and the publisher was doing stuff, and we were releasing the book, pre-orders, so many things happening. I was up, I used to finish work, come back, you know, spend time with the family, and I was spending time till about 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, working on the book, working, figuring out how to, you know, sort of go ahead with this. There are so many, you know, open items and moving parts, right? I used to get up at 7 in the morning or 7:30 in the morning, not feeling tired, because it gives you so much satisfaction, so much happiness that, you know, whatever it might be worth to the outside world, it's worth the world to you. as long as it's the, you know, it's worth the world to you, you don't feel like it's work. You don't feel like it's something that you have to do for others. Which is why I broke away from, you know, the rat race, as they call it, is because there is so much to be done in this one life. There is so much that you can do if you just get out of that fear, ki, you know, if I don't work and if I don't have that paycheck coming in, what will happen? You do, you know, you get out of that once, just once, and you realize how easy that is. And then, obviously, you got to have that one passion, that one thing that drives you, you know, and rest falls. So, I've done a bunch of things on the side, but this is something which is very special to me, and I'll keep doing it, whether it means staying up all night and doing it, because it doesn't fatigue me, right? So, yeah.